aligners. And aligners and how we understand the treatment as we should do with aligners. Aligners has been used many years and is a great tool, but mainly have been used a lot into the accomplishment of the cosmetic problem of the patient. But orthodontics is a little bit more powerful or more deep than only cosmetics. So we are in the page of accomplishing a nice function, a nice relation of the structures of the patients, and a nice relation of the airway, a nice relation of the joint, a nice facial outcome, and at the same time, a beautiful arch and a beautiful occlusion for our patients. So we are going to talk that we, in orthodontics, we are responsible of the face of the patient. We are responsible of the position of the bones. We are responsible of the position of the teeth. And now today, we have the aligners. Aligners that maybe sometimes we are isolating only on dental. Our patients are dental, skeletal, and facial. And we are responsible of the facial outcomes of those patients. So we don't want to isolate on dental. We are treating patients that have their face and can be more beautiful. We can convert somebody that is not attractive into attractive, or we can convert somebody that is attractive into non-attractive. So it's very important to balance beautifully the positioning and the structures of the teeth. So here we have the aligners, but we have the motion appliance that will establish a scenario of correction of the posterior segments. We will start in a scenario of accomplishing a positioning of the teeth that will establish a beautiful occlusion that will end up with a solid and consistent scenario for a beautiful class one relation at the end of the treatment of our patients for the years to come. The rotation of the molar is the keystone for having an exceptional stability on the sagittal condition of our patients in the future. So we need to accomplish a scenario of stability for our patients. How we will accomplish? Well, we place the motion, we convert a class two into a class one, or we convert a class 3 into a class 1, and from that point is when we jump into aligners, is when we jump into the aligning and accomplishment of a beautiful occlusion of our patients. Let's see patients. Patients like those. Patient like this one that is coming was a retrusive mandible, a retrognathic patient that is having an obstructed airway. The airway is obstructed. The positioning of the joint is in the wrong position. The patient is having pain and temporomandibular disorder of clicking and pain, and simultaneously is having problems when sleep because has the obstructed airway. So the question is, if the patient is coming to our office asking for aligners, shall we restrict the action into the cosmetic issue? I don't think that we shall, because we are orthodontists and we are responsible. We are responsible of the function. We are responsible of the face of the patient. We are responsible of the adequacy of the positioning of the joint of this patient. And we are also responsible of trying to enhance and open the airway of the patient. So it's extremely important that we balance all that, and then we jump into aligners. We cannot isolate into aligners just for accomplishing a cosmetic and dental treatment, because this is a human being, is a face, is a person that needs to be enhanced, and we are orthodontists, and we are focused on accomplishing a complete full service treatment of aligners. So in a case like this, that is 40 years old, and is coming with a class 2, with a retrognathic mandible, what we are going to do is we place the motion appliance. Now we have the clear motion appliance. This appliance that will enhance and will convert this complex class 2 in a simple class 1. But we are going to accomplish a beautiful class 1 of the posterior segments with a nice rotation of the molars and a scenario of simplicity and a scenario in which our case is going to be a simple case to produce, a simple case to finish. Simple case that can be beautifully finished with aligners or can be beautifully finished with braces. It's a simple case, a short treatment time. So we convert a complex scenario of class 2 into class 1. Now we have spaces in between the incisors. Now those spaces are easy to close. We can switch into aligners, and easily, changing aligners every 5 days because we are dealing with spaces, we are going to close those spaces and bring the position of the teeth in the correct, adequate relation. So we scanned. In 6 months, we went from a retrognathic scenario into an adequate positioning in a patient of 40 years old. The patient has not been growing. The patient just was invited to reestablish a correct scenario, a correct relation of the mandible in relation with the maxilla. That's all. We just reestablished the relation with the motion appliance. The motion appliance sent the mandible forward in this patient. The motion appliance invited this mandible to have a nice relation between nose, upper lip, lower lip, and chin. The motion appliance released the temporomandibular disorder, no more clicking, no more pain, and this patient now has an airway that is adequate in volume, that has a permeability on this, because we invited to this disc that was forward, that when the patient was opening and closing, was clicking. We invited to migrate into the correct positioning and establishing the adequate relation. This,
as long as I can remember, I've had clicking in my jaw. So when I eat, it's quite a pronounced click and quite painful at times. My top teeth were in front of the bottom ones and the jaw was receded. So the intention of the treatment was to bring the jaw forward and the teeth back. From starting the treatment, I was kind of conscious that my jaw had stopped clicking, because especially with something quite tough to eat, like toffee, for example, it would click quite loudly and it was painful.
Airway.
It's hard to pinpoint, obviously, a time when I noticed that there was improvement. It's almost like one day you realize, oh, that doesn't happen anymore. I'm not waking up in the middle of the night, short of breath.
Probably
relates to sleep apnea-ish. And that seems to have gone. That's why I mentioned it as being a positive thing.
So we are responsible of the airway. We are responsible of the position of the mandible. And treating with aligners does not mean that we can dismiss that. It's our obligation to provide a full service of treatment in our patients, even if we treat them with aligners or we treat them with brackets. So the motion together with aligners is what we call together is better, or better together, because we combine something that will balance the relation between the maxilla and the mandible with something that will have a second stage that will benefit the positioning of this teeth. Now, the scenario is perfect. Occlusion in class 1, spaces in between the incisors, switching aligners that will be closing those anteriors easily and bringing those anteriors into the correct position. We don't have any more a sagittal problem. We don't have any more a scenario in which we need to correct the sagittal, because the motion has done all the work for us in a spontaneous relation, okay? Now we place, we submitted that to Invisalign in this particular case, and then we received 28 aligners. 28 aligners, and that was from this posterior motion, post-motion scenario into the finishing for 28 aligners. So 28 aligners, changing aligners every 5 days, it's only 4 months and a half of aligners. So 6 months of motion in this particular case plus 4 months and a half, in 10 months, you accomplish a case of aligners that is short, that is transparent, that balances the face, balances the airway, that generates a correction at the temporomandibular disorder that the patient is having. So we have full service for this, and we do not isolate into cosmetic the approach of aligners. It's a big mistake to submit a case and just isolate on dental. We are treating patients, and we are orthodontists, and we need to be very careful about that. So we did an exercise, a very interesting exercise. Remember that we accomplished the class 1 platform, and we saw that with 28 aligners, we were able to finish. But what we did? Well, we submitted this case again to Align. We submitted this case again from scratch, and we said, hey, let's see if we isolate our action into the cosmetic. If we dismiss that this patient has a temporomandibular disorder, if we dismiss that this patient is retrognathic and snores in the middle of the night and break out without air, let's dismiss about if his airway is obstructed. We don't care. We were going only to focus on cosmetic. And let's see how many aligners we receive. Well, we submitted that, and instead of the 28 aligners that we were having after the motion, we received 83 aligners, 83 aligners to only restrict the action on cosmetic and forget it about TMJ or forgetting about all the things that an orthodontist has to focus, right? It's not correct. Tell me only one reason why I should submit and isolate the action into cosmetic and forget about what we can do for the patient. Tell me only one reason if it's worth to have 83 aligners instead of 28 and simultaneously correct with those 28 the problem of the TMJ, the problem of the airway, while with the 83 we only isolate our action on the cosmetic and we forget about the face or the retrognathic aspect of the patient and we forget about the airway. A single reason. There are no reasons. It's impossible. So the reason of the 83 is because this was a movement that was sequential. Well, this movement in a sequential is very nice, but we all know that what happened in digital probably will not happen in real. Real patients are a little bit more difficult or a little bit more different. So this is another subject that we have to take care of. Let's see another thing, which was the difference in number of aligners. In between the 83 aligners that we were receiving, we were having a reduction of a 66% of number of necessary aligners. So we were having a beautiful reduction of a 66% of number of necessary aligners and covering areas that the other approach was not covering. Look at this patient also, a patient with symptomatology at the temporomandibular joint, a professor that is having a class 2, and she is very concerned about the problem at the TMJ. So she's looking for a correction with aligners. But shall we restrict the action into just the cosmetic aspect of dental? Or is our responsibility to try to bring down a scenario of balance and adequacy of the structures at the temporomandibular level? In which what? In which we balance, we position the mandible better, and we release the positioning forward of the disc that will enhance and position that. So what we do is when we place the motion and we accomplish the, when we place the motion, regular motion, we start, and then in the second month we switch into a shorty because she was having a party and we decided to just place a shorty for the aesthetic purposes. We keep going, and now, after 3 months, we accomplish a complete different scenario. We accomplish a class 1, but a position of the mandible there.
When I was 18, I had TMJ problem, so it was very painful to chew, and when I would eat like a hard food, like a bagel or something, my whole jaw would feel like it was locking up. I'm a professor, so I do a lot of talking, especially in front of large classrooms, and so by the end of 75 minutes of presenting to a classroom of students, just the act of reading and talking repetitively was making my whole jaw hurt, and I realized I probably needed to take care of it. So far, the results have been amazing. I don't have any more pain, no more clicking in my jaw. It's been much better. I just thought I was always going to have to live with this jaw pain, so having them fix that so easily and pairing it with straightening my teeth back out was really a plus.
So it's very important and very interesting that if we can solve this problem, tell me a single reason why we have to submit the case from scratch with aligners and just isolate our action into the cosmetic issue and forgetting about the problem at the TMJ. We are orthodontists. We are not tooth straighteners. Tooth straightening can be done by a baby, but orthodontics cannot be done by a baby. So we need to adjust the positioning of the mandible. We need to adjust the structures. We need to adjust the function and the scenario. And this is crucial. So we receive after the motion, we receive 13 aligners, changing aligners every 5 days, short period. Then, with this, we received those 13 aligners that we didn't have to change a sagittal condition. They were only for positioning the incisors. Then we needed a refinement of 7 more aligners to close the spaces. This is smaller space. Okay, 20 aligners in total in between the refinement and the regular. Changing aligners every 5 days, we are talking about a full treatment of 7 months in total and 7.5 months in total of length. This is a short approach that covers the problem of the temporomandibular joint that establishes an adequate function and is not isolating the action into the cosmetic issue and is just focusing as orthodontist, not as to the straighteners, the positioning of the structure of the patient. And this is very important. We can finish in a short period of time. But we did an experiment. And we did this experiment and we submitted on this particular case, we submitted again the hypothetical option. Instead of focusing the case into the function, instead of focusing the case into releasing the temporomandibular disorder, we submitted the case to Align again and say, hey, you know, we will dismiss that you have this problem of the TMJ. We will forget about this and we will isolate only on aligning your teeth. So we will send the clean check from the scratch, from the beginning of the treatment, forgetting about your problem of the TMJ. So we did it and we received with this hypothetical approach of only aligners, instead of the 13 aligners that we received after the motion, we received 45 aligners. This is 71% more number of aligners and at the same time dismissing simultaneously the peripheral problems of the patient. Just focusing only on cosmetic. You know, cosmetic is not orthodontics. Orthodontics is global. The power of orthodontics is general, is joint, is face, is position of the mandible, is airway. This is the global. So the hypothetical case was pretending just distalize the uppers. Distalization of the uppers is not inviting the mandible to be relocated in a better position. And if we do not invite the mandible to be relocated in a better position, we are not going to release the disc that is forward and is generating pain and stress and temporomandibular disorder to the patient. So this is what we talk about, that better together, better starting with the motion, accomplishing a correct functional and adequate positioning in the relation in between the maxilla and the mandible, and then switch into the aligners. Not starting with aligners with no sense, with no project, with just the cosmetic aspect in our mind and dismissing important things. So the reduction was massive. 71% less aligners and covering all the aspects that an orthodontic treatment shall cover. So this is the important thing. Let's see this patient. Patient that was going to have surgery of class 3. Patient that was treated during 23 months with braces and they were preparing for surgery. And the day before surgery, he decides to go for a second opinion. Hey, is there any chance I can avoid the surgery? Is there any chance? I don't want to go into the theater and operate my jaw. I am fine. I need to find that. Well, we are having a patient that has been 23 months under orthodontics previous to surgery, and the day before decides he don't want to operate. So shall we keep this patient 24 more months on braces trying to solve that? No, it's better to clean. We clean that up. We just remove the braces and we say, hey, don't worry. We place the motion. And the objective of the motion will be to change the occlusal plane, invite this mandible to be relocated back, and change this and close the bite and correct this with a minimal invasive approach, a maximum respectful approach, and avoiding the unnecessary surgery for this patient. So we want to treat that with aligners. This patient has been many, many months under braces, and we don't want to go with more braces for this patient. It's almost 2 years with them. So we place the motion. We place the motion, and the patient accomplishes. In 3 months, accomplishes an scenario of class 1. Now we have a correct positioning. Now the motion has established a correct anteroposterior relation. Now it's not anymore necessary. It's not anymore necessary in the surgery. Now it's in the moment in which we scan, we place the aligners, and in a short period of time, in an ultra short period of time, we finish 4 months of aligners, 3 months of motion, 7 months in total. We run out of the surgery. We give an option to the patient. We give an alternative. We focus on the real needs of the patient with an orthodontic perspective. a perspective, not with a cosmetic perspective, an orthodontic perspective, which is the one. Here we have the patient finished in 7 months without the necessity of the surgery, and here we have the patient that is balanced. Now this open bite has gone, now this relation has gone. We have been able to treat it with aligners, but aligners not focusing on cosmetics, focusing on function, focusing on relation.
3 years ago, I realized that my bite wasn't good, my teeth and my jaw were like lacking. That's when I started to feel that I had to do something for it. They wanted to prepare me for a surgery. She recommended me that we had to do brackets and after we had to do an operation. So the day before the operation, we came to Career and he showed us the method that he has, and we were really, really, really satisfied. Because we were going to do something that it was a bit risky. And the motion appliance was the start of the treatment. It was really less invasive and it was really easy. And I started to feel like the changes in my mouth. And after we had the clear lens, the treatment is really easy to follow. The results are clear and are good. They are really good. I mean, why do you have to get a surgeon to operate you when you can do the same in half time without bad recovery? I mean, things that didn't make sense when you compare them. They didn't make sense.
So it's important when we prescribe to the patients. It's important when we prescribe to the patients that we think as if they were our family. And then we focus the attention on what we have to focus. Function is important. Face is important. Adequate positioning is important. The airway is very important. The joint is very important. And through working with aligners does not mean that we have to forget about all that and just a straightened teeth. No, this is orthodontist. This is real patients with real life, and we have to balance everything. And we can balance, but we need to hybridate to balance it. How can we hybridate? Well, mix up. Together is better, or better together. Start with emotion. Convert your case into class 1, even if it is a class 2 or a class 3. Then, from that point, short treatment of aligners and finish your treatments properly. Thank you very much.